그렇다면 2001년 영국 정부가 내린 살처분 명령은 피할 수 없는 결정이었을까요? 영국의 한 학자가 구제역 살처분에 대한 보고서를 작성했습니다. 인간이 만든 질병 구제역의 저자 아비게일 우주 교수입니다.
Key message was that the government's response to foot and mouth disease was a societal response. There was nothing about the biology of foot and mouth disease that demanded it had to be controlled by large-scale culling. It was a product of discussions that happened at a particular place in a particular time, which represented particular interest groups.
영국의 구제역이 들어온 것은 1836년. 치사율 80%의 우역과 달리 구제역은 치사율이 적게는 5%, 많아도 50%를 넘지 않아 농부들이 지나가는 질병쯤 여기던 전염병이었습니다. 하지만 영국의 상류층 농장주들에게서 구제역도 살처분을 해야 한다는 주장이 나왔습니다.
Now, of course, if we go back to the late 19th century when this policy was introduced, the wide spread experience of the disease was that it wasn't a particularly serious disease. It didn't kill animals. It did spread very quickly, but animals could recover from it. Also, at that time, there was no trading regime. There was no vaccination. There was nothing that demanded culling had to happen. So we had to it was important to explain then why this policy came about when it did. And I found that it was largely down to the interests of some very wealthy, very powerful livestock breeders who at that time held the balance of political power in Britain. They had the power to make a policy, and because their animals were valuable, they wanted them protected against all disease, not just diseases that killed them. So these pedigree breeders used their power in government to push through a policy that said foot and mouth should be made a government responsibility and that killing infected animals and the animals that they lived with should be the necessary way of controlling it.